Okay, in this section, we are going to focus on the trajectory generation. Robotic system, we have two types of motions. One of them is called the pick and place operation or point-to-point control. In this case, suppose that the end effector robot needs to move from initial position to a final position, and then you can select any trajectory between these two points. Only you need to avoid any collisions, and also to try to save energy for the actuators. That's the only condition for this kind of trajectory. For the second trajectory, we have, in this case, the continuous path that, again, we start with an initial position to a final position, but in this case, the end effector robot needs to follow a specific trajectory. For example, in this case, we have a straight line, but it could be any kind of function that the robot needs to follow. So in a block diagram, for the joint space control, suppose that in this case we have a desired point, and then you will need to include the inverse kinematic model, because in this case you are in Cartesian coordinates and need to transform these Cartesian coordinates to a joint variables, and then you need to find these position, velocity, and accelerations trajectories that the robot need to follow for any of these point-to-point, and then this is going to use it as an input for the joint space controller. And then the controller is going to send the torques or forces to the robotic system, and using a feedback signal, we compare these two values in order to accomplish the desired final point. For the task space block diagram, in this case, again, you receive a desired point. But in this, for this example, now you don't need the inverse kinematic model, so you can use directly the Cartesian coordinates and apply the trajectory generations for the position, velocity, and acceleration motions that going to use as an input for the controller. But in this case, it's a space control, a tax space controller that generate a Cartesian force that need to transform to the joint force for the robotic system. And then the robotic system, again, you're going to use any sensor to have this feedback signal for the joint variables. And then, instead to use the inverse kinematic model, you need to use a forward kinematic model in order to transform these joint variables in a Cartesian coordinates that is going to use to compare with the desired coordinates. Now, focus on the joint space trajectory, or the point-to-point control. In this case, we have this complete control diagram, but for this section, we only focus on these two blocks, the inverse kinematic model and the trajectory generation, and then we are going to eliminate the controller for this moment. Later, we are going to include that part, in order only to verify these trajectory generations. So let's start with a cubic polynomial function in order to solve these trajectories. You can use any function, but the most common and the most basic function is this cubic polynomial, because you can find the derivatives for the position. So in this case, you have a cubic for the position polynomial, and then the derivative is going to results as a quadratic function, and the finally the second derivative is going to result with a linear function. So that's why it's the basic function used in these interpolations functions. Now, let's start with the position. This is the general equation for the cubic polynomial. So in this case, we have four coefficients in function of the time. And then using the initial constraints, remember that we start in time zero. And then in time zero, we receive as information the initial position for the joint. And then also we start with velocity zero. For the final time, we also receive as information the final joint variable. And also we want that the n effector remains in that position, and that's why the velocity is zero. So these four constraints can be established in these equations, and then using the position cubic polynomial, we can find the derivatives for velocity and acceleration, and then substitute these constraints in our equations, resulting with these four final equations. With these four equations, the idea is to find the remaining coefficients. So here we have the first coefficient. This is the second coefficient. And the remaining coefficient is A2 and A3. Solving for these four equations results with this solution for the coefficients. So these are the four coefficients that now we can substitute in our three equation of motions. Now, let's apply using this example for these planar robotic systems with 2 degrees of freedom. In this case, suppose that we want to move this robotic system from an initial position for the first joint variables, theta 1, from 20 degrees to 50 degrees, and for theta 2, for 25 degrees to 65 degrees. So that is the initial conditions. And we want that this robot moves from 0 to 5 seconds. So using this cubic polynomial function, and then use it for these two joint variables, we start with the position equation, the derivative, and the derivative of velocity for the acceleration. And then for 5 seconds, we can use our four coefficient results for these two joint variables. So let's start with theta 1. For theta 1, these are coefficients, substituting the values for the initial and final desired position for the theta 1. And for theta 2, again, we have these four coefficient results. So, finally, this is our three equations for kinematic motion, position, velocity, and acceleration that's going to follow a cubic polynomial for the position, and a quadratic function for velocity, and a linear function for acceleration. And they are going to follow this initial condition for the joint variable 1 and 2 in 5 seconds. Now, with these six equations, we can use a program. In this case, we can use the Octave or MATLAB program. In both of them, we can use this function. Let's use a main function. So let's start with the parameters that we use. Phi and 3 for the lengths of link 1 and link 2, the initial position for the join variables 1 and 2, for the final position for the join 1 and 2, the final time, 5 seconds, and how it's going to use this discrete division that we are going to use. We are going to use a 0.1 divisions, and let's start with the initial counting for 0. That's the initial for the for loop that we have here, from 0 to 5 seconds for any 0.1 seconds. Let's increase this variable I that is going to calculate all these equations that we have already done in the last slides. And then we store these values for the position, for the position velocity acceleration for the first join and position velocity acceleration for the second join. Now, using this information, we can substitute in a plot in order to have a graphical way to show the motion of the robotic systems and also the plot for the this kinematic motion for position, velocity, and acceleration. This is going to do this motion using the inverse kinematic solution that we have already done for the join variable 1 and join variable 2. And then this is our final drawing for the robotic system. Now let's see what is our results. So we select the, remember that for this robot we can find two solutions. So we have the elbow down or elbow up solution. So let's select the elbow down solution for the inverse kinematic solution. And the results for this motion is this plot. So this is the first position, the initial position for the initial condition for theta 1 and theta 2 for this planar robot. And then this is our trajectory for the n effector, and this is going to result the final position for theta 1 and theta 2 that is required for the problem. Now finally, let's take a look for these plots for the kinematic motions for theta 1 and theta 2, where we have the first blue function for the position, the red one for the velocity, the green one for the velocity, and the red one for acceleration. So as we can see here, we start for position for 20 degrees and finish in 50 degrees. And for the join 2, we start in this value and then finish in this position, end position, 65, I remember, 25 and 65. Mm-hmm. So, also, we can see here that because it's a cubic function for position, we can see this curve, and the derivative for velocity, we have a quadratic equation. This is the green one here. So we start in zero velocity and finish in zero velocity. And the acceleration, is the red one, is a straight line. That is the derivative for the quadratic equation. That is the straight line that in the maximum value for the velocity, it's the acceleration is zero. That is the case here. So this is very typical, these plots for this kind of cubic polynomial function for this trajectory planning.